And this is the Swan River during the Whitewater Festival. The festival is an annual event that happens the third weekend of May. In 1976, Fritz Grahnke put up $100 in prize money to have the first organized race. 11 kayakers showed up. Today, there can be as many as 150 rubber-suited racers. Kayak racing down one of the most dangerous stretches of raging white water in America is why the festival is so popular. It's called the Wild Mile. The deafening roar of the river and kayakers risking their lives is enough to capture anyone's attention. The kayak is a canoe of Eskimo origin. It is propelled with a double-bladed paddle. The kayak has a sharp bow and stern and no keel. Eskimo kayaks are built by shrinking seal or other animal skins over a wooden frame. They are used for hunting because of their noiseless approach. Modern kayaks are made of plastic and fiberglass. In 1865, John McGregor, a sportsman and traveler, fashioned a deck canoe derived from the kayak of an Eskimo. In the United States, the term canoe is usually reserved for the open canoe. The term kayak is used for decked paddling canoes. Looks like a member of the rescue team is going in to save a kayaker. Sometimes a kayak gets caught in a swirling mass of water called a back eddy or wash. There's not much this man can do except drop a rope and hope the kayaker can pull the craft out of the whirlpool. In this situation, they will be lucky to get the rescuer out alive. Smile, you're on Wounded Cam. This man was caught by our Wounded Cam, and he's still standing after surviving a major dunk in the river. In 1865, John McGregor designed a deck traveling canoe, which he named Rob Roy. And in it, he made a journey of the waterways of Europe. The first Rob Roy had a length of 15 feet and a beam of 30 inches with paddles, mast, and sail. It weighed 90 pounds. McGregor's following canoes were shorter and carried a mast and sail inside the cockpit in order to be able to make use of favorable winds. The Rob Roy canoes achieved great popularity, and soon racing models were developed called single streaks. Between 1920 and 1930 came rapid developments from Scandinavia for racing and touring kayaks.